The Good Witch, coming from Hallmark, is one of the best adaptations ever created. The show is close to its 7th season, with Cassie Nightingale as the main character and the head witch. And fans are really excited for the very anticipated season. Now, even as the most dedicated fan, you might think you know everything about the show, but keep watching to see some surprising facts that only a few fans noticed. Grace age. First, did you guys know that The Good Witch is a movie that came out in 2008? Exactly 7 years before the series. Because of the great popularity of the movie, an adaptation was made. In The Good Witch movie, Brandon and Tara explained to Cassie they would get married in 2 years, and this is after Grace was born. Now, here's what a fan noticed. Based on what we said before, Grace would be 2 years old at the wedding. Well, that's not the case when they got married. Grace was 5 years old. Moreover, in the first season of The Good Witch, it seems like 5 years have passed. Well, how was Grace 15 years old now? Sarah, power hidden pregnancy. Most fans were pleased to know that the show will return for its 7th season on the Hallmark Channel. Season 7 will premiere Sunday, May 16th at 9, 8 Central on the Hallmark Channel. Until then, we can binge watch the show again on Netflix. Season 7 will include Sarah Power, who, to your surprise, was pregnant while filming Season 5. The actress has many famous roles throughout her career, including those in American Pie, Beta House, Schitt's Creek, and Designated Survivor. She plays Abigail Pershing in The Good Witch, and as we all know, her character is of a big significance. So, according to Distractify, the actress was pregnant during Season 5, and no one noticed. The actress later welcomed a baby girl in May 2019. In addition to Sarah, the Season 7 cast is expected to include James Denton as Cassie's husband Sam, Kylie Evans, Stephanie, Catherine Disher, Martha, Peter McNeil, George, Scott Caverio, Adam, Reese Matthew Bond, Nick, Paula Bedreau, Dottie, Catherine Beryl, Joy, and Mark Bendavid as Mayor Donovan Davenport. Right now, there's no news for new members in the next season. We won't see the return of Bailey Madison as Cassie's daughter, Grace, who left the series at the end of Season 5 because, as she said, she wanted to focus on other projects. No matter what, fans are really excited for the next season, as there are so many questions after the Season 6 finale. The movie versus the series. Good Witch received very good fans' feedback with its amazing storyline and even more amazing twists and turns. The show simply puts you in a good mood with its light, sweet, and funny excess. As we previously said, Good Witch is an extension of a series of movies of the same name. The show is focused on the little town called Middleton. The city is small, so everyone knows each other and they help each other as much as they can. Two families are in the center of the show, the Nightingale and the Radfords. The Nightingale family includes Cassie, a widow, mother of two children, Grace and Brandon, of the marriage between her dead husband, Jake, and his first wife, and owner of the Gray House, a boarding house, and her popular bells, books, and candle stores, Tara, Brandon's wife, George, Grandpa and Abigail, and Cassie's cousin. Good Witch is in a way continuation of a series of 7 made-for-TV movies of the same name, which were released in 2008 and 2014. Dedicated fans know that the movies were all about Nightingale's marriage with the police chief and her development throughout the seasons. Sadly, the actor who portrayed Nightingale's husband was not hoping to appear in the show, hence his character dying, and the show is set years after that.
The Chocolate King is in the Gray House.
And it is made all the more regal.
You must be Abigail.
The Lake Houses. Throughout the show's 2nd season, we witness Sam buying a lake house after looking for a safe place for him and his son Nick. He's with Cassie when they decide to go home together. Now, some fans notice what seems like a mistake. The mentioned lake house is shown in the episode Family Time, when Sam, Cassie, and their kids go to the lake house for a weekend. Why didn't we see the lake house since the 2nd season? Also, more importantly, why are the two lake houses completely different? Have you noticed this before? Let us know in the comments. Also, is there any other mistake you noticed? Reese Matthew Bond, Nick, is British? In the show, Reese Matthew Bond portrays Sam's troubled son, Nick. Throughout the show, we've seen his character growing and being more behaved. His transformation is certainly one of the best in the show. Nick graduated and went to California for college, and his father knew Middleton would be the perfect place to raise his kid. Only a few fans know that the actor who plays Nick, Reese Matthew Bond, is British. No one noticed this because he perfectly speaks the North American accent. Check some interviews with him. You'll be shocked.
But I can't tell if this is the horse or the candy shop. There isn't a puzzle of a horse in a candy shop, is there?
No.
Magic view. There are many things that make this show ranging from every other show we get these last few years. Since everything we have is either a remake or a sequel, it's really rare to see a good adaptation, whether from a book or a movie. Thankfully, The Good Witch is a perfect example that adaptations can be good. Yet another reason for the show's success is the use of magic in it. Nightingale is complex. That viewers often ask themselves if there's magic or she's simply that good with communications and understandings. As a result, every fan experiences the show in a different way. You pick your own perspective in the show, and that's amazing. Error. Here's something that you definitely didn't notice. This detail comes from a very dedicated fan. If you remember during the series, Sam says his 1967 Camaro was a Z28. The car shown in the series is from the 80s, and it was an SS model, option code Z27, based on the front fender and grille emblems. The Z28 choice was not available on the SS, because the SS used larger engines, so Sam having an actual 1967 Z28 is quite not possible, as only 602 were made. The police chief's comments as to the trim levels were somehow correct. The three option trims were RS, SS, and Z28, and it was likely to buy an SS or Z28 with the RS appearance option. In the case of the SS, making it an RS/SS. The Lights Festival. Despite the errors and a few mistakes, the show succeeds to deliver what it promises. It keeps us entertained as it shows us a story full of fun and shocking twists, but mainly entertaining and full of really fascinating messages, which can make you think about your life as its stories are often relatable. Let's be honest, who doesn't love a show that will make you think about your life choices and reconsider some things? Sometimes they help you understand events of your life better than anything else, or the choices of the people around you. While The Good Witch has a good number of amazing stories, another fan noticed how the second season is full of hard-to-notice mistakes. Here's an example. At the end of the second season, everyone is getting ready for its light festival that occurs every December. However, in the series special that premiered after the second season, it was somehow Halloween. When an author, Jessica Carrington, is releasing the book at the Gray House, Cassie sets it into a Halloween party. Now, Bell and Denton did a joint video announcing Good Witch's Season 7 renewal in July 2020, but there's still no official trailer for the next season. When it comes to what we should expect from the next season, according to Hallmark's official press release, the events of Cassie, Joy, and Abigail, and what they found at the end of Season 6, will begin a new mystery for the cousins to unravel. Have you guys ever noticed some mistake or an interesting detail in the show? Also, what are your theories about the upcoming season? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed our video, make sure you subscribe to our channel so you never miss any of our videos in the future. As always, thanks for watching, guys.